Let's see how to perform a second trimester screening test with SsdwLab 6. We must enter to the web program, so we should introduce our ID and password to log into the web. It will appear several options and we choose Add New Patient. The first folder is Patients folder. We can observe an edit bar just below the tabs of the folders that allow us to add, edit, delete, save, and cancel. These buttons appear on all folders as we will see. In the Patients folder we must enter the data identifying the patient, surname, name, CIP, and date of birth that will let us calculate the age of the patient. In the section called Others, we introduce the race of the patient, which is a correction factor. And in this case the patient is Caucasian. We mark the patient as a patient test. The option Patient Test makes that all information relating to this particular patient and its screening is considered by all program options as a test. So this screening will not influence in the quality controls and will not intervene in statistical calculations. The next folder is Pregnancy folder. In this one we collect information concerning the pregnancy. The minimum information required is the weight of the patient, which is a correction factor. The origin of the ova and the pregnancy type, we leave the default option, and the number of fetuses, in this case is a single fetus pregnancy. In case if it was a twin pregnancy we could define the placental type, mono or dichorionic. The following folder is the screening folder. We must enter the date of screening. That is the date of blood sample extraction. We also introduce the screening profile. We chose a double test, that it is a second trimester screening test. We can observe that there is a section regarding previous anomalies, and another that refers to the correction factors. We can note then white race is marked, as we have previously defined. The next is blood test folder. We enter the date of the sample which normally coincides with the date of screening. We will also enter the values of Gaussian biochemical markers that in the double tester, alpha-fetoprotein and human chorionic gonadotropin plus beta. The following tab is ultrasound folder. We introduce the date of the ultrasound. Then in biometrics sector we mark use this to calculate gestational age. And we introduce the value of BPD. We can detect how the weeks and days of gestational age are calculated. We can observe that there is a section called fetal dichotomous markers where there are several second trimester dichotomous markers such as echogenic cardiac foci, ventriculomegaly or nuchal fold thickness, that in case that the value is yes, the risks increases. And finally we come to the last folder called risk. We find on the top of this folder information about the Gaussian markers used in risk calculations. Thus we see the values of the markers and their respective MOMs. In the middle left we observed correction factors. In the middle center the dichotomous markers measured. And in the middle right we see the estimated risks, maternal age risk, trisomy 21 risk, trisomy 18 13th risk and neural tube defects. These are represented by colored bars, green when the risk is low, red when the risk is high, and the risk of maternal age is always displayed in yellow. In the bottom left of the screen there is information relating to gestational age estimation. In the bottom center there is a box that lets you enter details that will appear in the report. And in the bottom right there is a section that, after completing the relevant tests, we may introduce the diagnostic values, trisomy 21, trisomy 18 13ths and neural tube defects. On the left side of the screen there is an informative summary of the patient's screening, where appear the screening date, the center, the screening profile, the gestational age, the risks, the MOMs of Gaussian markers, the correction factors and dichotomous markers, if they have been used. If we go back to the screening folder and we click to the button Add, we could apply other screening test to this patient. Now we choose a triple test, which is other kind of a second trimester test. In the blood test we can observe that now we have three different Gaussian markers. Alpha-fetoprotein, second trimester free beta-human chorionic gonadotrophin, and unconjugated estriol. Once we introduce the value of all markers, we go to the next folder that, as we have seen before, is the ultrasound folder. Once we add the value of the BPD, the risks are calculated. We can observe in the risk folder the values of the Gaussian markers, their respectively MOMs, and the risk for age, trisomy 21, trisomy 18 13ths, and neural tube defects. Then we go back to the screening folder again, and we proceed to perform a quadruple test that is another type of second trimester test. So as we did before, we click to add button and we select quadruple test from screening profile option. Then we save and we pass to the blood test folder. We note that there are four Gaussian markers: alpha-fetoprotein, HCG plus beta, unconjugated estriol, and inhibin A. We introduce the values of the Gaussian markers. In the next folder, we introduce the value of the BPD used to calculate the gestational age. We observe that the gestational age is automatically calculated. Finally, we go to the risk folder. As we have seen, we can observe that the MOMs are calculated as the age risk and the final risk for trisomy 21, trisomy 18 13ths, and neural tube defects. We can observe the presence of two buttons. One is the validate button for validating the screening, and the other is the report button. If we click the report button, a report in PDF format is generated in a new tab. What we see is what will be reproduced in the printed report. We can see represented in bars, risk for age, risk for trisomy 21, risk for trisomy 18 13ths, and neural tube defects risks. So following these steps, we have performed different kinds of second trimester tests.